Hello, welcome to my channel. Today I will teach about how to do your assignments well written and to make it look tedious. In this video, I will cover up a lot of things, including how to do your page breaks, how to do your session breaks, how to do page numberings, and also some useful shortcut keys to save your time doing the assignments. To my viewers, I honestly hope that you will watch this video patiently until the end of this so that you can learn something new. And the reason I ask all of you to watch this video until the end because I encountered a lot of people, a lot of my friends asking me how to do your assignments well formatted, how to do the page numberings, how to do the section breaks, how to do the page breaks. So, enjoy my video. First part, I will teach about how to use the page breaks page, section breaks next page, and also section breaks continuous. Alright, page is to separate between two pages, and for the section breaks next page, you want to insert another section, but it is on the next page. On the other hand, for the continuous section breaks, you insert another section, but it is on the same page. Alright, and that's it. But before that, I'm going to tell you something in case you did not know, which is this button right here. We call show/hide button. You can see right there, as soon as I click that button right here, and you can see all the editing that you have done to your document. Your page breaks, your section breaks right here, your spacebar right there, all the editings. Alright, for the first part is the page break. Let's say if I want to add something right here, basically I just click enter, enter, and enter, and nothing happens. It does not change anything beneath that. But what happens if I remove the page break right there? Simply remove this thing, and I want to add another thing right below the reference. Enter, enter, and enter, and you can see it affects all the thing, and it makes your document become untidy maybe. So just click like that, layout, go to break, and then go to page breaks. There you go, you got all the things perfectly balanced. And next is the section break continuous and next page. For this document, I did not use the section break next page as it is already used in this document by the original author. I'll be using the section break continuous right here, and this one is to insert under the section but on the same page. As you can see right here, I write already the title, the front page, table of content, and then right here I wrote the abstract, and then right there is introduction. It's basically another section, but it is on the same page because I use the section break continuous. Just click right here and then go here, and then you got the continuous section breaks. Alright, for the section break next page, I will be using another document, which is to clearly demonstrate how is it like to use the section break next page. Alright, this is my own document, my own assignment. It is the clear sample to show you how to use the section break next page. Alright, you can see there, I put the section break right there. And then page break right here, page break, another page break, another page break, and another page break. Alright, the use of section break next page and all the section breaks that I told you before is for you to put the page numbering. Alright, let's see here. If you put another section, it basically separates between section. This one is section 1, and this one right here is section 2, and this one right here is section 2, section 3. Alright, What is the difference between each section? Well, you want to put another thing on if each section. For the section one, want to put the front page, front cover. For the second section, you want to put the table contents. You want to put the abstract. But then for the third section, you want to put your contents. That is the function of the section. Basically, you can use anything. Like here, go to page number, go to format page number, and then you can change that. This is for the section 3. But you can see that here, for the section 2, my page number is different. There, I use the Roman 2 one, not the numbering one. I use the Roman one because I put the section break. That is why I can use two different page numbering. And that's it for the page break, section breaks next page, and also section breaks continuous. Part, I will teach about how to use the column and also text wrapping. Okay, let's look at the text wrapping first. Right here, I have the text wrapping and I erase that. There you go. It erased the spacing between the image and also the text. But if I put that back, go to break, go to text wrapping, and it provides a space between your image and also your text. Alright, going on to the column break. Let's see right here. Alright, column break, you got there. You can see after I wrote all these things, and then I want to separate between the columns, and I put the column break there so that I can break between the column right here and the column between that, and it become tidy. Let's say if you want to put the breaks and put column break, and there you go. You separate this column until this here, and then with this one, same goes to another column right here. You put breaks, go to column, then right here. See, you can separate between all the column that you use so that it make it looks way tidy, it looks way well formatted. Alright, that's basically it. The next one is how to use the breaks, section breaks, even page and odd page. Honestly, I myself did not use this format that much because it is not that much of use. For an example, if I want to use the even page and odd page, for the first page and third page, odd page numbers, I want to put my text. But then for the even page, like 2, 4 and 6, I want to put images. Well, there's not much of research that requires me to do things like that. So here's an example of an even page and odd page format. Okay, right here I have the section break odd page, and from 1 equals to 3 because I use the section break odd page right here. And then going to the next one, goes to 4 because I put the section break odd page right here. Okay, basically that's it regarding the section break even page and also odd page. If you want to add, go to breaks and then go to odd page, and then there you have it, page 1, and then you got page 3. Alright, last but not least, I would like to share with all of you how to do your tips simpler and save a lot of your times. Alright, before this, I teach all of you to click here, go to the breaks. This is the manual way to do your work, but you can just use shortcut keys so that it saves your time. Okay, you can just use alternate, and then as you can see, you can choose various type of tabs here. So you want to go to the layup, click alternate again, go to the P, then you have B to go to the breaks, and then click something. Then you want to go next page, so click P, and then you go. There you go, you have the page break here. Another thing, if you want to add section break, maybe just click N. Right, you have that. Okay. There's also shortcut keys that I would love to share with you guys. Is the shortcut keys for undo button and redo button, which is the Ctrl Z for the undo and Ctrl Y for the redo button. So this one is manual. And this one is the shortcut keys one. Ctrl Z, Ctrl Z, and there you go. This is at the first step of this document. Ctrl Y. There you go, you have that one. Ctrl Z to go to the back. Alright, you can also use Ctrl A to select all of the thing that you want, that you have. Okay, so that's it for the shortcut keys. And for a smart student, I would like to teach with you, with all of you, how to do your assignment draft. Okay, so you can just follow this step, so that every time you want to make your assignment, just simply click this draft, and then you can just type your assignment here. Okay, go to the alternate, go to the B, go to the B, go to the next section. Next section. Okay, you have section 1 here, you have section 2 here. Okay, click again, alternate, click B, click B, and next page. Okay, there you go, you have 3 section here, section 3, section 2, and also section 1. Alright, there's reason why you want to do 3 section. The first section is you want to do your title, and the second section is for you to write the table of contents or your abstract maybe, and then you have your section 3 to do your contents. Okay, so this is how to do the page numbering. Go to here, footer, and go to page number, go to format page number, and then go to this. But it won't appear because first you need to do this, click page number, click bottom of page, let's wait here a bit. Okay, and then go to one, and it will appear. But you don't want to put anything here because this is the cover page, so simply click this and it will vanish. Okay, for the second section we have number 2, but we don't want to use this yet, we just want to use the Roman 1. So choose here Roman 1 and start at I. Okay, click OK. Then there you go, you have Roman 1. And for the third page, or this is the first page of your contents, this is not correct, so just pick this, go to format page number, and then 1, and start at 1. Okay, and there you go, you have it, your draft is complete. And that's it for my extra section. Throughout the video, I teach all of you the things using Microsoft Word, but I didn't even mention about Google Docs. Well, in Google Docs, you can use the page number, you can use headers, you can use footers, you can use page break, the same as Microsoft Word. But then, look at this, you can just use Ctrl Enter. But in Google Docs, you don't have the show or hide button, so it's hard for you to see what you have done to your assignments. And another one is this one. Let's click here, with page number and more option. Well, for my video, I teach all of you the use of page breaks, the use of section breaks, and page numberings, which includes the cover page, the Roman one, Roman 2 for abstract or your table of contents, and also the normal number 1, 2, 3, and 4 for your contents. But for Google Docs, you cannot use Roman 1 or Roman 2. You can just use number 1, number 2, and number 3, and so on. Look at this. And here's the reason why I prefer to do my assignments in Microsoft Word instead of Google Docs, because in Google Docs, you cannot use the Roman 1 and Roman 2 for your page numberings. And that's all from me. Thank you for watching my videos.